This is just a sample of the audiobook. To get the complete audiobook, access the link posted in the first comment.
When a Midwest farm girl named Teresa Halbach went off to college in Green Bay, Wisconsin, she found her calling holding the camera. A short distance from Lambeau Field, she started making money as a part-time photographer at Green Bay's West Side Shopping Mall. To her family, Teresa Halbach was the happy-go-lucky, aspiring photographer. She took photographs at weddings and also snapped children's photos. But after graduating college, Teresa started dabbling in more risky, provocative photography. She had a wild and crazy side. Future employment prospects with X-rated magazines such as Hustler and Penthouse were not out of the question. I gave my permission to Ms. Halbach on a number of occasions to use my photography studio for nude portraits of her clients. In fact, a portion of my own business was taking nude photographs of my clients, reflected Tom Pierce, owner of Pierce Photography. During Teresa's last year of life, she was sucked into some of the darkest corners of the web. Her business, Photography by Teresa, was out hustling for new sexually explicit photography clients, people who needed someone to capture them in more daring and provocative poses. One court exhibit notes, Photography by Teresa is adult entertainment products and services, photography, portrait photography, professional photography, special occasion photography, visual arts company. Get in touch with Photography by Teresa with contact details. Many years after his understudy's untimely and gruesome death, photographer Pierce was asked to review Teresa's business profile, advertising her adult-oriented photography services. Based upon my personal knowledge of Ms. Halbach's business, that is an accurate depiction of the services offered by Ms. Halbach in the regular course of her business, Pierce said. Besides her nude photography business, Halbach also hit the back roads for Auto Trader magazine. She snapped photos of cars, trucks, and vans that people desired to sell. This work was concentrated around the Green Bay area, including Sheboygan and Manitowoc counties to the south. With Auto Trader, a number of the men she encountered found she had sex appeal. They were attracted to her small frame and wanted to experience her wild side. Pierce recalls, "In March 2005, Ms. Halbach told me a male Auto Trader client made sexual advances toward her and invited her into his residence. Teresa told me that this advance made her feel uncomfortable." After this incident, Ms. Halbach did not mention any problems with Auto Trader clients. Specifically, Ms. Halbach never expressed concern about going to the Avery property. Yet before she disappeared, on Halloween 2005, Halbach had reason to be apprehensive. Her life was in grave danger. "I was aware that Ms. Halbach was getting phone calls from someone who was harassing her," Pierce said. At the same time, a messy divorce case at the Brown County Courthouse in downtown Green Bay was also preoccupying her time. A husband and wife who lived near Green Bay had used her nude photography services at her Green Bay studio on Western Avenue. But when the couple's rocky marriage crumbled, Teresa began a romantic relationship with the man who was almost a decade older than her. He ran a wedding disc jockey service and worked for a Green Bay television station. Teresa had taken nude photographs of Bradley and his wife. After this, Bradley and his wife had broken up, and Teresa started dating Bradley. Teresa and Bradley would only have sex, and Teresa did not have any feelings for him, and it was only physical. Bradley and his wife were having problems at one time, and he would confide in Teresa about his problems. On the day before she died, Teresa exchanged emails with a supportive friend who encouraged her efforts to grow her adult-oriented photography business. "Hey, Teresa, it was great to hear about your busy life. Sounds like so many good things have changed for you in the last year. I'm so happy to hear that business is good. Sounds like you have many hobbies and things going on. That's great. I'm envious and wish I could make the time for that. I wouldn't have imagined Adrienne asking you to take nude photos of her. That's cool, though, that she's comfortable enough. Maybe we could pass your name around for porn shots." 5 weeks earlier, a guy named Ken sent an email to Teresa's photography business thanking her for the letter and package she sent him. He wrote, "And the package? Well, I think you take better care of me than my mother does. Well, I think that's a good thing. I wouldn't want my mom sending me a porn. I really appreciate everything. Damn it, I really want to talk with you. I really miss you, and really thank you for sending me messages to my beeper. I should be back online Monday. Hopefully we can talk. I miss you, and thank you very much for the goodies. I'll let you know the results. Bye. Ken.